Tonight I'm trying a slightly different style of beer than I usually have. This is Times Changed High and Lonesome Ale, named after one of the coolest, funkiest little bars in Winnipeg, the Times Changed High and Lonesome Club. Neat little hole in the wall place that always has really good live music. There's some really cool artwork on the cover, and 10 cents from each can goes back to the artist, so I can definitely support that. So let us start with the openings. This one says Universal Probe Test Leads Pin. That could very easily be what it is. Or, yeah, it could be a plastic sheet. But no, it is test probes. These are kind of an old school style test probe. They're a hard plastic, and they have very similar to the little screw latch thing for the wire that banana jacks have. So you just strip a little bit off the wire, shove it down there. It comes out through this little hole here, and then you lock that down onto there. And I got those to go with this little meter here, these little mini banana jacks that I got in a previous mailbag, and this silicone test lead wire that I got many weeks ago in a mailbag. I know I'm probably not going to use this thing that often, but I'll use it a whole bunch more if I actually have test leads for it. One pair Universal Probe Test Leads pin for digital meter, multimeter, etc., etc. I got these for $1.95 Canadian with free shipping from, well, it doesn't matter what this seller's name is, because they are no longer on eBay after selling just shy of 70,000 items. But as usual, I will link you to a search term that does find a couple of people selling them anyway. And here's one of those. As you can see, there's nothing too special about these. These are just old school probes. They claim that they're polyamide, brass, and stainless steel with nickel plating. Yeah, they probably have at least two of those things. But I don't see too much else to say about them other than what we already saw when we were looking at them in person. So there you go. Next in says lighting fixture. A little bit small for a lighting fixture, but you never know. What? Yeah, okay. Oh. Yeah, okay. I think I remember this. Let me just... Yeah, I think that's how it's supposed to go. Basically wraps around your hand and that, and then gives you a couple of little work lights. Obviously, I wasn't super serious about this thing when I bought it, but I saw it and it seemed goofy enough to throw in a cheap bid on. So here we are. Nightlight waterproof fishing gloves with LED flashlight, rescue tools, outdoor O2. Yeah, I did get this at auction, and I must have been drinking, or it was late at night, or all of the above. But I actually paid $5.07 of my Patreon's money for this. Oops. I will link to this, even though it was at auction. There should probably be, yeah, there's some similar ones up here. On the other hand, it did come with batteries, and it says that they're two CR2016s. Don't know what else to say with this other than, sometimes the late night purchases just get you. And apparently nobody else wanted to bid on it. Although, you know, as goofy as it seems, for working on things up underneath the model railroad or in a dark corner somewhere, that might be okay. I don't know. Maybe it's not such a stupid thing after all. Time will tell, I guess. All right, what's next? No customs declaration. Came through the Canadian reshipping warehouse in Mississauga. Well packaged, whatever it is. They didn't want it getting broken. It is, just as it says, a 2.2-inch SPI-controlled TFT module. On the back, it identifies itself as 240 by 320, 2.2-inch. And we have Multimeter clock chip select over on that side. We have a SD card, full-size SD card there. And Same pins on the other side here with an added VCC and ground and LED. Okay. That should be interesting to play with. Something to add to my display boards collection. I think that's one of the larger ones that I've got as well. So that should be good. 2.2 inch TFT LCD display module. ILI9341 SPI 240 by 320 451 /AVR/STM32/ARM Arduino. Currently going for 1474 American or 1872, but when I bought it, it was 1297 American or 1647 Canadian with free shipping. These things always seem to change. Oh well. So what do we have down here? 2.2 inch dot matrix, 240 by 320. Yeah, four wire SPI. 262K or 65K color depth. I'll have to look that up and find out exactly what they're talking about. Size, yeah, it has four LEDs and uses the LA9341 driver, for which there are libraries for all of your popular microcontroller modules, including one library provided by Adafruit to the official Arduino repository of libraries. Next in, we have cable sleeves. A fairly big package it is, too. Not the biggest today. As you may have noticed at the beginning, there is one much larger one. Oh, looks like HEATSHRINK. A bunch of red HEATSHRINK. Okay. Three different sizes, always a handy thing to have in stock. Thing here. I've got a fair bit of HEATSHRINK in various different sizes in stock, and I can pick up black HEATSHRINK quite cheap at Princess Auto. There's some eighth inch stuff there, and they've got it in different various different sizes, and it goes on sale all the time, but they've only got black. And I tend to use HEATSHRINK a lot on power cables, especially, although, you know, there's lots of other applications for it. Obviously, anytime you don't want a wire to have bare bits shorting out on something else. So yeah, nice to have it in different colors, and red and black are obvious for, you know, color coding power cables.
16 feet HEATSHRINK 2-to-1 tubing electrical sleeving cable wire HEATSHRINK tube. I've got three different sizes. I got 5mm, 8mm, and 10mm, all from Serenat Zero. The 5mm cost me $2.49 Canadian. The 8 was $3.80, and the 10 was $4.69 with free shipping. Woohoo! They do actually have an assortment of colors, so I probably could have gotten some more. But we'll see. I'm not sure if I want to have, maybe green would be useful for doing grounds and stuff separate from negative power. I've got some yellow, maybe a bit of blue, I don't know. We'll see. Shrinks 2-to-1, voltage of insulation rating 600 volts, not sure if I would trust that necessarily. Once it's shrunk, you can use it anywhere from stupidly cold to stupidly hot. Where is 125 degrees Celsius melt temperature, or the shrink temperature? Wide range of uses. Yeah, there you go. Cut, slide, shrink, use.
And the big one. Now, I know what this is because there's nothing else this big and heavy that I ordered. Plus, it said what it was on the outside of the box on the shipping label, even though it came from a Canadian seller. Have you guessed it yet? How about now? Let me just get this guy out of here, and then we'll take a proper look at it. It's a Variac! I got my own Variac. I've wanted one of these for, you know, decades and decades, back when I was doing a lot of work on analog audio electronics and whatnot. It was just always a sort of a thing that you'd like to have, it'd be handy to have, but I just could never justify it or afford it. But now, thanks to cheap electronics and the generous help of my Patreon supporters, I was able to find this one. And as I mentioned, I bought it from a Canadian seller, and with shipping and everything, that was absolutely the least expensive for exactly the same part number. You can get these on eBay or AliExpress or Banggood or wherever, or Amazon, but I just happened to get this on eBay from a Canadian seller. It says that its output is good up to from 0 to 130 volts AC at 60 hertz. Input is obviously going to be 110 or whatever is coming out of the wall. It's 1000 VA. So if you have a perfectly resistive load, that means 1000 watts. I'm not going to go into VA right now because it's a little bit of theory and I've exhausted myself on theory in that last video. The input fuse is 10 amps at 250 volts. That should be just fine. Oh, it even says 10 amp fuse right there. Okay. So what a Variac is, it's an auto transformer. It's not an isolation transformer as you normally think of transformers. It has a two windings, a primary winding that's connected here, and a secondary winding, which the wiper of this knob taps into at various different points. Ooh, that's kind of wonky. And adds the secondary voltage to the primary voltage. You can actually sort of see it through there. Sort of. Can I see the wiper going by? Can you? No, you can't. Anyways, I'll give this guy its own video because it deserves it. Plus, before I power it on, I want to just open it up, make sure that the earth ground is grounded to the case and passes through, and that generally the wiring inside it is safe, because with mains-powered stuff that, yeah, okay, I bought it from a Canadian seller, but it still was manufactured in China and is a very inexpensive piece of kit for what it is. So I'm going to take it apart, take a look inside it and everything, fix up any bad connections or loose connections or anything weird that I find inside it. And that will be an upcoming video.
Variac transformer, variable 1000 VA AC voltage regulator, copper coil, 110 volts, 0 to 130 volts. I got this from Keygive 1 in Richmond, British Columbia, Canada. Currently, he is selling it for $92.99, but as you can see, it's been updated. It was $86.22 when I bought it. Free shipping then, and still has free shipping. There's a lot of other sellers that sell these things, and because it's so heavy, you may want to, if you want to buy one, you may want to search around on your local websites or the international version of eBay, search for your own country, stuff like that, just because it's the shipping that's going to kill on this thing. But yeah, there you go. You can see there's an American seller that's got it for $76.89, but just shy of $50 shipping. And these are all exactly the same ones. Here's some a little bit better quality ones. Probably they've got metering and stuff on them, digital metering, but I just got the least expensive one I could find, as I typically do. So there's all the specs. There's not too much surprising there, not much different than what we've already seen. It says the dielectric strength is good for 1500 volts for a minute. I don't have any way of testing that, so I'm not going to. Pure copper coils, yada yada. Pretty much what I described, there is the specs. Maximum output 10 amps, sort of, I guess, depending on whether you got a resistive or an inductive load, I guess. But typically you would use this with something a lot smaller. Something like a tube amplifier would be ideal, especially if you're testing it and you know it hasn't been turned on for a while and it may have dry shorted capacitors or something. Slowly bringing up the voltage may tell you its secrets before it explodes in a cloud of smoke. I'm looking forward to getting into this real soon and playing with it, and then just having it available for when the need arises, when I need to repair something where this would be an appropriate tool.
Well, I'm pretty pleased with that assortment. Let's just quickly go through the shipping times. The Variac took less than a week because it was couriered from Vancouver, or Richmond. The HEATSHRINK took 44 days. The TFT screen took 11 days because, again, it used the Canadian reshipping warehouse. These test probes took 39 days. And the funky little glove-like thing took 36 days. The more I look at that, the more I think it might actually be useful for a few applications, especially if those little 3mm LEDs, they're fairly bright, but they're not, and it's only going to be, 20 milliamps, so that pair of batteries in there will probably last a good long time. You know, build those up and stay tuned real soon now for a video diving in under the skirts of this thing. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Once again, I really appreciate that. Questions and comments down below. And as always, thanks to the generosity of my Patreon supporters for keeping my beer fridge full and keeping the mailbags rolling in. But I just couldn't keep doing these mailbags without the Patreon folks. So cheers to you guys. Thanks for watching, everybody. I will talk to you later.